Good morning, seventh grade students. All right, if you want to hear something hilarious, I started filming the eighth grade video earlier today, and I realized that my microphone wasn't even plugged in. So I had to redo the whole thing over, so it was fun. Not the whole thing, I only did like the first 10 minutes, and then I realized that it was no good. But we are fully working right now, so that's good. Let's start. I'm starting with the distributive property with negative numbers. This one should be nice and quick and easy because I think you all were getting this pretty well the other day. So I'm just going to do it real quick. Now, real quick, you see this 5 outside the parentheses, then it has the multiplication sign. We're going to write it like this, no multiplication sign, because that's the way we've been writing it this whole time, right? If you want to put a little dot, that's okay to signify that it's multiplying. But you don't need to have the dot, okay? Anyway, we have negative 2w minus 4. So let's distribute this 5. So that means we're going to multiply everything inside times 5. So 5 times negative 2w, that makes a negative 10w. And then 5 times negative 4 makes a negative 20. And once you have this, can these be combined? You ask yourself that. Can those be combined? They cannot, because they do not have the same variable. So they are not like terms. So we are just going to enter these as they are written. Okay? Negative 10w minus 20. Check it. Hooray. So, yeah, let's move on. I was cracking my knuckle with this chalk. I keep breaking the chalk, guys. At this rate, I'm going to be without chalk by the end of the week. That's not good. I mean, I'll have chalk, but it's all going to be little pieces. All right, which expressions are equivalent to 35 plus 30s minus 45t? Oh my gosh, let's write that down. Let's write that down. Oh, whoops. There we go. Let's write that down. 35 plus 30s. And I write my S's small so that they don't look like a 5. And then minus 45T. And I make my T's curled so they don't look like a plus sign. Let's see. Which of these expressions is equivalent to this expression? Choose two answers. Well, let's look at all the answers. This first one that has a 7 with it. Let's do mental multiplication. 7 times 5, that makes 35. That's good. 7 times 30s, 7 times 3 makes 21, so 7 times 30 is 210, which is not in our equation. So it's not A. Let's check the second one. 5 times 7, that makes 35. 5 times 6s, that makes 30s. And 5 times negative 9t makes negative 45t. I like this one. This one works. But they say to pick two answers. So it's going to be B and let's see what else. Negative 35 minus 30s plus 45t times negative 1. Well, if you multiply this whole thing times negative 1, let's try it. What's negative 1 times the first number? Negative 1 times negative 35. If you multiply anything by negative 1, it turns it to the opposite sign. So this negative 35 will become positive 35. This negative 30s will become positive 30s or plus 30s. And this plus 45t is going to become minus 45t. So that's exactly what we have. So I'm going to choose that one. That's two answers. That's two answers. If you check this one, this D actually looks like it might be also correct. But if you notice, 10 times 3.5, that makes 35. That would work. 10 times 3s, that would make 30s. That would work. Then they do 10 times negative 4.5. That would make negative 45. But we have negative 45t. So D looks like it would be an answer, but I think it's just going to be B and C because they tell us to choose two of them. Let's do it. Check. Hooray. Let's keep going. Next one, let's use the distributive property on this next expression. Now you notice that in the parentheses they have minus 7c plus 8d. Oh, whoops, not 81, 8d. And then they have the number being multiplied at the end. Personally, I don't like that. I like having it in the front because it's just it's a habit for me, okay? So let's see. 0.6 times negative 7c. Well, 0.6 times 7 is 0. Well, 6 times 7 is 42. So 0.6 times 7 is going to be, if you use your calculator or if you multiply by hand, it's going to be 4.2c. In fact, it's going to be negative because it's got a negative there. So you have negative 4.2c. So it's kind of like you could either use a calculator here or just multiply mentally. 6 times negative 7 is negative 42. But since we have a decimal, you put a decimal. Okay? Negative 4.2c. All right, 0.6 times 8d. 8 times 6 is 48. So 8 times 0.6 is going to be 4.8 because the decimal gets moved. Again, if you have a calculator on your laptop, you could also use that. But you get both of these. Now, are these like terms or not? If you said no, you are correct because they are different variables. So since they're different variables, you just have to write them down just like you have to type them in just like you have it on your paper. So plus 4.8 D and check. Hooray, we did distributive property. Good job. And then finally, this is another one where you have to choose multiple answers. So let's show you the whole equation. It says, which expressions are equivalent to 10a minus 25 plus 5b? 10a minus 25 plus 5b. What is equivalent to this? Well, let's see. I'm just gonna write them down. I'm gonna write down the first option real quick. And let's try it. What's 5 times 2a? That makes 10a. Good. 5 times negative 5, that makes minus 25, which is what we have right up there. And 5 times b is 5b, which is what we have up here. So the first option works. Let's select it. It says choose three answers, and there's five total. So we're going to have to choose three answers. Let's look at the second option. The second option, let's see. The second option is, I guess I'll just write it down. Negative 2 times minus 5a minus 25. I already think this is going to be incorrect because that minus 25 looks too big for any of the numbers that we have up here. But let's try it. Negative 2 times negative 5a. Oh, that makes 10a. That works. Negative 2 times negative 25 makes positive 50, which is not what we have up there, so option B does not work. Option B does not work. Let's try option C. Option C, that's going to be 10 on the outside of the parentheses, and the inside of the parentheses is A minus 2.5 plus 0.5B. Let's see. Multiplying by 10 is easy. 10 times A, 10A. 10 times negative 2.5 is negative 25 because you moved the decimal. And then 10 times 0.5b, 10 times 0.5 is 5, so we got 5b. Is this what we had in the beginning? Yes, it is. So option C works. Now we just have to find the third one. I'm just going in order. Let's try option D. Option D has negative 5 outside the parentheses, and then inside the big parentheses is negative 2a plus 5 minus b. Let's try this distributive property. Negative 5 times negative 2 A is positive 10a. Negative 5 times positive 5, that's negative 25. Negative 5 times negative b makes a positive 5b. Is this what we had in the beginning? This is indeed what we had in the beginning. So the third option is D. Those are the three that I just got that are equivalent to this. We just showed the work and we showed that it's the exact same as this. So let's check it now. Yay. We did it. Hooray. All right, so, wow, that was only 10 minutes. Jeez. Okay, good job. Let's move on, guys. So we just did distributive property with negative numbers. Now let's do equivalent expressions. I mean, this is like, yeah, I mean, I'm just gonna go in order. I'm just gonna go in order. I mean, I know that you're allowed to go out of order because these are all review topics, but I am just going to go in this order. So let's see. Which expressions are equivalent to negative F? Imagine that instead of just getting an F grade, you get a negative F grade. That would be ultimately bad. But anyway, let's move on. Okay. Let's look at this expression. Whenever you have distributive property, that means you're going to multiply. So let's do it. What's negative 5 times 2f? Negative 5 times 2 is negative 10f. I'm going to bring down this minus f. Minus f, bring down minus 10f. Negative 5 times negative 3, negative times negative makes a positive 15. And then are there any like terms to combine? Well, minus 1f minus 10f, that makes minus 11f. And then plus 15. So all I did was I took the original expression and did distributive property, and then we combined like terms after that. Which of these expressions is equivalent to that? Well, this one's exactly it. Yeah, cool. Okay, again, this might seem kind of tedious, but this is the kind of stuff where people make the most mistakes. When there's negative numbers involved in distributive property, that's like the number one thing where people make mistakes. So let's try it this one. 3g. 3g plus 6 times negative g plus negative 5. Let's do distributive property. So 6 times both of these things. All right, so I'm gonna bring down the 3g because that can just be brought down. Then I'm going to do 6 times negative g. 6 times negative g, that's gonna be negative 6g. Next, we're gonna do 6 times negative 5. That's gonna be negative 30. Boom. So we've simplified a little bit. Now let's combine these two terms. 3g minus 6g. You're going to get a negative number that's going to be equal to negative 3g minus 30. And then at the end, these two things cannot be combined because they don't have the same variable. So are any of our options up there? No, negative 3g minus 30 is not up there, so I'm going to put none of the above. Next one. Next one is 5 plus negative 3 times 6x minus 5. Okay, do you see how here's the big parentheses and here's the number outside? So you're going to. Multiply that inside this parenthesis. So negative 3, let's bring down the 5. The 5 is the easiest thing to bring down. Negative 3 times 6x. Well, negative 3 times 6 is negative 18. So you get negative 18x. And then negative 3 times negative 5 is going to make plus 15. Because negative times a negative makes positive. And now that we've simplified a little bit, let's combine the 5 and the plus 15. If you combine those, that makes a plus 20, or positive 20. And then plus negative 18x, well, I'm just going to put minus 18x. Now, you could have put negative 18x and then put plus 20. You could do it in that order. But, okay. Let's look at this answer. Okay, so let's look at our answer, and let's look at the ones they have up here. So the first option actually looks a lot like our answer. But the truth is, we have a negative 18x, and what do they have? They have a positive 18x. Also, we have a positive 20 in our answer, but they have a negative 20 or a minus 20 in their answer. So even though this option A looks a lot like what we got, it's actually not. It's like opposite signs. So this is not equal to what to option A, okay? Because the signs have all been switched. Not only were the numbers switched, but the signs were switched, okay? So I'm going to say none of the above. Hooray, four more. All right, let's do this next one. Next one says negative 3 times 2w plus 6, close parentheses, minus 4. Okay, negative 3 times that first number. Negative 3 times 2w, that gives you a negative 6w. Negative 3 times 6 gives you a negative 18. And then we have a minus 4 after, so let's write that down. Cool. And now, are there any like terms we can combine? At home, you should hopefully see that there's some like terms to combine. They're these. Minus 18, minus 4. So if you lost $18 and then you lost $4, that means you lost $22. And then minus 6W. Bring that down. Let's see. Is option A equal to what we have? No, it's not. Is option B equal to what we have? Well, let's see. 2 times negative 3W, that makes negative 6W. So far, so good. Then 2 times negative 11 makes negative 22, which is also what we have. So option B, after you do distributive property, it's the exact same thing we have. So option B is equivalent. Yay. Yay, yay, yay. Okay. Let's keep going. This is all just combining like terms. This is like crazy. This is easy. I think we're going to do one more after this then. Okay, 5p plus 3p. Hopefully you already have combined like terms in your head. If you do 5p plus 3p, you get 8p, and then plus negative 9. And then these two cannot be combined. So let's see, which one of these is 8p plus negative 9? Our option A looks like it, but option A says positive 9. We have a negative 9. So that ain't it. Option B has, well, I'm going to write option B down because I don't want to have you do that mentally always. So let's try this. 3 times P is 3P. And then 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. So let's write that. Do I have room underneath to write it? I guess I'm just going to write it. I'm going to erase this. 3 times P is 3P. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. And then plus 5P plus 5P. And then it looks like we have a 3P and a plus 5P. So if you combine those two like terms here, you get 8P. And then you have this minus 9 just hanging out. So minus 9. 8P minus 9. Which is what we have. So yeah, the second option gets you 8P minus 9. Which is what it says up here. Well, here it says 5P plus 3P, but we know that's 8P. OK, Okay, more combining like terms. Let's do it. Which of these expressions is equivalent to 2 times negative 6c plus 3 plus 4c? Well, let's do distributive property. 2 times negative 6, negative 12c. 2 times 3, you should know that's 6. And then finally, plus 4c plus 4c. Okay, let's keep simplifying. Negative 12c plus 4c. It's like you lost $12, 12 coins. You lost 12 cents, but then you found 4 cents. That means you only lost 8 total cents. So minus 8c plus 6, because plus 6 gets brought down. Which of these options is equivalent to that? Well, option A is... And then option B, let's try option B. Option B is 3 on the outside of the parentheses. Write this down, please. And then 4C plus 2, and then plus 4C. Let's check if this also gets us this expression, okay? 4 times negative, 3 times negative 4C is negative 12C. 3 times 2 is 6, and then plus 4C. Oh, this is the exact same expression that we had in the first problem. So, yeah, the second option is also equivalent. Let's check that. Yay. Next question. This is the seventh question here. So, which one of these is equivalent to this expression? Well, let's see. Negative 2 times 2h plus 10 plus 4h. Let's try it. Negative 2 times 2h. It's going to be negative 4h. Negative 2 times 10. It's going to be negative 20. And then bring down the 4h. And then let's see. Minus 4h plus 4h. These two are opposites. I hope you remember what happens when you combine opposites. When you combine two things that are opposite, they cancel out. They equal 0. So we are left with simply negative 20. So let's look at which expression is equivalent to this. Well, negative 20 was the answer we got, so let's choose that. And then let's look at option A. It says negative 20 minus 4h plus 4h. So if you think about it, minus 4h plus 4h, those are opposites, so those are going to cancel just like ours. So this one is also the same thing that we got. Let's check. Yay. Show summary. Keep going, keep growing, 7 out of 7. Look at me go. Look at me go. What's this board? Oh, the whiteboard. Yeah. Okay. Very cool, very cool. Yeah, that was it. That was it. Let's see. Let's do two-step equations. This is the final assignment that I'll do for the day. So seventh grade, you're only expected to do these. And this is just solving equations. This is the one where whenever you solve equations, you do a dotted line down the middle. Okay? So do you see the variable, d? We want to get d by itself, so we don't want this 12 next to it, and we also don't want this minus 7 next to it. So hopefully you remember, what do we get rid of first? The constant or the coefficient? At home, hopefully you're thinking about it. The truth is that you get rid of the constant first. So to get rid of this minus 7, you do the opposite. You do plus 7 on both sides, okay? Plus 7, plus 7. Let's see what happens. 41 plus 7, 48. Minus 7 plus 7 cancels. And we get 12d. Now we just have to get rid of this 12 coefficient, which is being multiplied right now. So how do you get rid of times 12? You do the opposite of times 12, which is divide by 12. That's what this little fraction bar means. It means to divide. So 12d divided by 12 gets you 1d equals 48 divided by 12 is 4. So d equals 4. Boom. Now we have distributive property. It might be the chalk making me cough right now. This is insanity. 9. And then p minus 4 equals negative 18. Dot down the middle. 9 times p. 9p. 9 times 4. 36. So that's minus 36. Let me make that shorter. Equals negative 18. Okay, so we've done the distributive property. Now, let us get rid of the constant first. Okay, get rid of this constant. How do you get rid of minus 36? You do the opposite. You do plus 36 on each side. So let's do the easy part. 9p, bring that down. Minus 36 plus 36 equals 0. Negative 18 plus 36, or 36 minus 18, if that helps you think. 36 minus 18 actually gets you 18. So we are left with 9p equals 18. So 9 times what equals 18? Well, if you divide both sides by 9, you will see that p equals 2. If I can scoot that up, p equals 2. So please copy down that work. P equals 2. I'm going to hit enter. Hooray. 5 more problems, then we're done for the day. All right? I think so. Yeah, it's like 26 minutes already. Yeah. 5 more problems. We got it. Let's keep going. Stay strong. Stay mentally strong, everybody, okay? Mentally strong. I beg of you. All right, here we go. 24 equals dot, 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 dot. 3 times n minus 5. Let's do it. Distributive property over here. 3 times n, 3n. 3 times 5, 15. And you put a minus sign there. And you bring down the 24. Next, we want to get n by itself. So you need to get rid of the constant, then the coefficient. How do you get rid of this minus 15 constant? Think at home. How do you get rid of minus 15? Do the opposite. Plus 15, plus 15. If you do that on both sides, this side is going to be 0, so you bring down a 3n only. Oh my gosh, that's the worst 3. That's the worst 3 I've ever seen. 3n equals 4 plus 5, 9. 2 plus 1, 3. 3n equals 39. How do you get rid of this 3 coefficient? You divide by 3. Divide by 3, so we're going to be left with 3n divided by 3 is 1n, 39 divided by 3 is 13, n equals 13. Hooray. Ooh, this one looks fun. This one looks very fun. 3 equals dot, 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 dot. G over negative 4 minus 5. I'm going to show you how easy this is, okay? Still, you want to get rid of the constant first. That's the first thing you want to do. So minus 5 to isolate G. How do you get rid of minus 5? What's the opposite of minus 5? You add 5. Put a big line. If you see opposites being combined, that equals 0. So we are left with 3 plus 5 is 8, and we're left with g over negative 4. Okay, g is almost by itself, but it's not yet by itself. Oh, can I? Wow. Wow, dude. Guess what I just learned? That you can use a pen. I mean, I'm using my whiteboard, but I didn't realize that you could use a pen to show work on this on these problems. That's amazing. Okay, g divided by negative 4. Well, what's the opposite of dividing by negative 4? And divide by negative 4, what's the opposite of division? Multiplication. So we're to get rid of this divided by negative 4, you're gonna do times negative 4 on each side. Make sense? Times negative 4 on each side. So if you do negative 4 times g divided by negative 4, then times negative 4, those are opposites. So it will just end up equaling 1. So it's going to equal g divided by 1. So you end up just getting 1g. 1g equals negative 4 times 8. Well, what's 4 times 8? That's 32. Negative 4 times 8 is negative 32. So g equals negative. Oh, whoops, I gotta scooch over. There we go. G equals negative 32, okay? Negative 32. Check it. Let's keep going. Stay mentally strong, guys. You guys are killing it, all right? What? I can't even see you, but I can already tell some of you are working very hard, all right? I like that. That's good. That's very good. All right, here we go. 7n minus 4 equals 31. Dot, 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 dot. Here's the variable n. Get rid of the constant, then get rid of the coefficient. So get rid of this negative 4 constant. What's the opposite of minus 4? Do plus 4. Let's do that. So minus 4 plus 4, that's equals 0. So you bring down only 7n equals 31 plus 4 is 35. Oh, we know this. 7 times what makes 35? 7 times 5 makes 35. Here's the step to get 5, you know? Yeah, so n equals 5. Hooray, we got two more questions, guys, then we're done. We are done, done. Well, we're done with the video. You guys still gotta turn in the assignment, you know, but. Okay, 42 equals dot, 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 dot. Negative 7 times z minus 3. Let's do it. Negative 7 times z is negative 7z. Negative 7 times negative 3, negative times a negative makes a positive 21 equals 42. Okay, now let's get z by itself. Let's get rid of the constant first. How do you get rid of this plus 21? You do the opposite of plus 21, which is minus 21 on both sides. Never forget both sides. Plus 21 minus 21, opposites equal 0. So you bring down minus 7z only. And then on this side, 42, well, let's do subtraction. 2 minus 1, 1, 4 minus 2, 2, boom. Final step to get z by itself. Well, you want to get rid of this negative 7 coefficient. So you divide by negative 7 on both sides. And negative 7z divided by negative 7, that equals 1z. And 21 divided by negative 7, 21 divided by 7 is 3. So divided by negative 7 would be negative 3. And negative 3 goes in there. Solid. Next question. Oh, they gave us the easiest one to end with. That's so nice of them. So nice of them. In fact, I think you should do this one on your own, but you know, if you're honestly still struggling, you're more than welcome to keep watching. But I'm telling you, it's easier if you do it. 2 times t, you tell me, that is 2t. 2 times 1, tell me, that is 2. Equals 10. Here's the variable t. Let's get rid of the constant first. How do you get rid of this plus 2 constant? You do the opposite. The opposite of plus 2, minus 2 on both sides, right? So plus 2 minus 2 equals 0. So you bring down just the 2t that's left. Equals 10 minus 2. Oh my gosh, that's so difficult. And then 2 times t equals 8. So 2 times what equals 8? 2 times 4. So t equals 4. Okay? Hooray! Look at that. Oh my gosh, I went real quick through those last ones, but that's all right. Please, 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 if you feel like, oh man, this is so easy and this is just review for you, please do the other assignments then. Challenge yourself, all right? Make sure you're doing stuff that is, tricky. I want to show you something, by the way. Isn't that cool? This is a game of, it's Pac-Man, but you move the, instead of moving the character around, you move the board around, and the character just falls to the bottom of the map. So you gotta be careful about how you move the Pac-Man thing. So yeah, I just wanted to show you that. That was kind of cool. That, and I got a cool studio. I got a cool studio where I can do raps. All right. This is where all the raps go down, where they all get created. Okay. So, and then this right here, somebody's making dough. Okay. You like that? You like that? I'm sure you do. All right. And here's our classroom. Okay. And then during passing period, this is where we do our champs expectations. All right. These kids are not following champs. They're all out of line. They're sitting on the floor. There's a kid with a beanie. This is honestly, this might look like a normal hallway, but this would not fly at Fairmont, all right? All jokes aside, I want you guys to have a wonderful, wonderful day. Stay safe, stay healthy. Please drink lots of water and wash your hands, all right? Keep working hard, and I'll see you later.